alienated allies, UK, Israel, Australia, Egypt, break with Barack Obama, by William Patterson for Guerrilla News. There's a saying, remember all the people you step over on the way up? They're going to be stepping on you on the way down. Obama alienated traditional allies in favor of enemies, then he decided to pick a fight with Israel on the way out. Except that some America's closest allies, the one he had been the most determined to alienate from the start, including Israel, decided that they weren't going to put up with it anymore from a lame duck weasel. Netanyahu struck back, and he struck back hard. Obama Inc. was not expecting that. Israel's policy had been to strive for bipartisanship, to keep things outwardly friendly, no matter who was in office, and to say nothing bad about Obama. And Obama had counted on that civility over the years to pull assorted dirty tricks on Israel, from espionage on behalf of Iran to attempts to force Netanyahu out of office. And then, with Trump as the winner, much of the Jewish liberal leadership backing Keith Ellison and refusing to do the right thing on Iran, the dam broke. But Obama's people thought it would strictly be a fight between Israel and Obama, and his powerful media corps of admirers, not to mention the rest of the world. Except something funny happened on the way to the lynching of the Jewish state. The UK PM directly criticized Kerry's remarks on Israel. Australia made a point of parting ways with Obama. Egypt leaked a transcript that showed Obama had been behind the dirty UN resolution trick. Despite all the media's hysterical claims, close US allies are preparing to work with Trump, and they despise Obama. And quite a few of them are happy to give the pretentious, treacherous, and inept Nobel Peace Prize winner a sharp kick on the way down. The UK has not forgotten Obama's Brexit threats or how he blamed its government for the Libyan war. Obama counted on the Brits to stay silent, just like Israel, but he failed to realize that he has lost power and everyone hates him. They always did. He's a snake in the grass, and treasonous and treacherous and pretentious, all of the above. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.